you could start seeing that they're getting engaged, they're getting inspired.
It's a way to get young girls involved in engineering early.
This is an opportunity. This is something they could do, and that's attainable. And it gives them an opportunity to see what we do behind the scenes.
Around 148th grade girls from schools across the Winston-Salem area are focusing on STEM at Collins Aerospace in Winston-Salem, taking part in Introduce a Girl to Engineering Day.
That's kind of the age group where they kind of lose interest in STEM. And we're trying to, honestly, end goal, we're trying to hire some of them here in a few years. We'd like to encourage the young women in this area to go for an engineering degree because this is a really great field that they might not really know about.
Tuesday, the girls toured the engineering development lab where airplane seats are built and tested for commercial aircrafts, and they even learned how to design things of their own.
I just like how it's like hands-on.
They showed us a lot of stuff that you didn't think engineering involved engineering, like a pillow. A pillow involves engineering. I didn't know that.
It's a way to get more women thinking about future careers in a male-dominated field.
It's about 15% across all of engineering. So it's not that this company isn't good at hiring women, and that's why there's like 1 to 2 women on every team. It's just we need more people to go into this field so that we can hire them to work here.
Inspiring young minds and getting them engaged in engineering early can make a huge difference later in life.
I love math and science, and so I would have a lot of fun with it, I think.
Before this, I didn't really know what like engineering was. And then now we've got like examples of it like in person rather than just like reading about it in school. Doing right now. It's really fun.
Collins Aerospace is hoping these girls walk away with an open mind, seeing that they too can pursue a career in engineering one day.
I've always kind of thought about engineering, but I've definitely seen some parts of it that I haven't seen before. It's been really interesting.
We need to be able to design for everyone, so how are we going to know if we don't have those voices in the room when we're making decisions?